Hello guys, my name is Hardevinder. Today we will solve this assignment of 7th class, this practical sheet, this one. Let us learn how to solve this. We have to solve this, we'll have to apply the formulas according to the directions which have been given in this assignment. As they have written, open the Microsoft Excel, type the contents in Excel worksheet as given in the figure, which I have already made. All the contents I have already entered in the worksheet. Worksheet is already ready. We will have to apply the formulas in this. How to apply? Let us learn. Here we will have to calculate the sales revenue. Sales revenue and in this is cell A6 and this is B6 and this is B7. In B7 we need to calculate sales revenue. These 3592 are the units which we have sold, and the price of per unit is 40. So we need to calculate the revenue. For calculating revenue, we will multiply units sold, multiply by price per unit, product price per unit. Means units sold are here in B6, price in here in B17. So we need to calculate the revenue. When will calculate revenue? Very first thing you know, for writing any formula, very first thing you need to write the is equal to sign. Then click here to take the unit sold, multiply, and click here to get the price of per unit. So B6 is the unit sold and B17 the product price. Then press enter. We need to show, actually it's showing the formulas, we need to hide them. Show formula. So this is the sales revenue. Similarly, we need to calculate the sales revenue of this Q2, Q3, Q4, all. If I'll copy the formula like here, what's happening? When I'm copying here, this unit sold is B6 and here C6. That's okay. When I'm copying the formula, relatively the reference is changing from B6 to C6. But the price here is B17, but when I am copying the formula, its reference is changing to C17. Nothing is there in C17, so we don't want that. This price reference should change, means this price reference means B17 we need to keep the absolute, and the B6 which is a relative, which reference we need to change from B6 to C6, but we don't want that. This price reference should change. So price reference, where it is, this is B17. We can keep this as an absolute so that it should not change. So for making it absolute, we can put the dollar sign before both the coordinates. So when I'll copy this formula from here to here, you can check C6, here it is a B6, here it is C6, but B17 will remain same. B6, but B17 will remain same. B17 will remain same, means we have put the absolute reference on this reference. When we are copying the formula, this reference will not change relatively because this is the absolute reference, but this unit sold reference will change as we want to change relatively, but this price we want to keep the same. That's why. Now cost of sale we need to calculate is equal to unit sold and multiply it by product cost. And product cost again we need to make absolute. For making it absolute, we need to put the dollar sign before both the coordinates, means before B and before 18, or you can press F4. It will automatically be a absolute. So in this way again we can copy this. So now we need to calculate the gross margin. Gross margin is sales revenue minus cost of sales. That will be the gross margin. So here is equal to, this is sales revenue B7 minus cost of sales, and then enter. This is a gross margin. So we can copy this formula like this. For copying, you can click here in a cell pointer and drag right your cursor in this way. Now we need to calculate the total expenses. For total expenses, these expenses, sales force expense, advertisers expense, and overhead expenses, these expenses we need to calculate. Click them and press auto sum button. This is a auto sum. Automatically the all total expenses will be calculated, then copy these like this. Now we have calculated the all the total expenses. Now we need to calculate product profit. For calculating a product profit, we need to deduct gross margin, means we need to deduct from gross margin the total expenses. After that we can get the product profit, means gross margin, here is gross margin minus total expenses. In this way we have calculated the product profit. So copy this formula, and we have calculated the product profit also. So now we need to calculate the sum of all these items, means unit sold, sales revenue, cost of sales, and all expenses, and profit also. We need to calculate all these. So select like this and press auto sum. Automatically the sum will be done. Here also select these and press auto sum. So we have calculated, make them bold. So this is your worksheet. This is your practical task which we have completed. Hope you have learned this. Thank you very much.